Hey, Jason here, and this is how to live edit audio for streaming using OBS Studio, one of the most popular streaming softwares of all time. I've done similar tutorials in the past, but I must say, this is the simplest process to get great sounding edits thus far. I've had the effects on since the beginning of this video to give you a quick preview, but let's turn those off to get back to sad, unedited audio so you can judge for yourself if you like these edits. We're going to use 6 filters within OBS Studio to accomplish the effect that you just heard and hopefully like, but it's actually simpler than it sounds because 3 of the effects are included in OBS Studio stock, and the other 3, I'm offering my full settings for you to get started with right away. I'm also going to do a live preview, so as I progress through the tutorial and add filters onto my voice, you'll hear the effect they have in real time, starting with right now, no effects. Let's get started. Here's a things you'll need roundup. First, OBS Studio, which I assume a good portion of you out there already have if you clicked on this video, but if not, just download it and set it up like any other program. Additionally, you're going to need 3 third-party VST plugins, TDR Nova, TDR Molotok, and TDSer. These are 100% free, linked down below, and super easy to set up considering the setup processes for all of these are basically identical. And the installer for all 3 of these, the version of the plugin you want, is 64-bit VST2. It doesn't mess anything up to install other versions, but you can save space and time by just making sure 64-bit VST2 is the only selected option. But this next step is very important. When the installer prompts you for where to install the plugin, make sure it's one of these locations. The locations I popped up are the places OBS Studio scans for plugins, and of course, you want the plugins to work with OBS Studio without any hassle. I've been showing the setup process here for TDR Nova, but like I said, the setup processes for the other 2 are identical, so just do the same thing until all 3 plugins are on your computer. Okay, actually starting to build out the effect, let's jump into OBS Studio. We're naturally going to head to the mic/aux section because that's the audio that's going to get edited, and then click the gear, and then filters. And we're going to get started with the first effect, a noise gate. A noise gate will cut out the audio when the volume falls below a certain point. You've probably heard a gate being used as most streamers will use this, and it's most noticeable when it's configured incorrectly. You hear like a pop when someone starts talking after a moment of silence. But don't worry, we're going to configure ours correctly. So click the plus sign, okaying the name OBS has given this filter, and then dive into the settings. Keep in mind going forward, I'm going to name all my filters as the function they perform, but the name doesn't really matter. So my settings are on screen now, and I've set them by watching the sliding volume bar of my mic in the audio mixer. The closed threshold is the level the audio needs to drop to cut out the sound, and I set mine around a whisper's level. I did this because it's a good middle ground between the background noise, which is obviously significantly quieter, and my actual speaking voice, which is significantly louder. And I set the open threshold a bit above that, which is the volume the audio has to rise to in order to open the gate back up. And the attack and release settings control how fast the gate opens and closes, and the hold is the minimum time it'll stay open for. There's reasons for tweaking these, but I'd say start with what's on my screen. The most important thing, though, is ensuring the thresholds that actually trigger the gate are working well with your mic and voice. Next, let's hit the plus and add a VST2.x plugin. This is going to be an equalizer, and we're going to select TDR Nova from the dropdown. This is an EQ plugin that hopefully will show up for you if you did everything right in the installation process earlier in the video. But now let's open the interface and take a look at the settings. Okay, so an EQ is meant to organize frequencies in your voice, cutting out the bad ones and boosting pleasant sounding ones. Let me go a bit more into detail though and explain what each individual section does with my specific settings. From left to right, I have a high pass filter that cuts out the rumble frequencies, a section that maintains core frequencies, a cut at the box frequencies, a boost of the byte frequencies, a boost of the high frequencies, before finally a low pass filter that cuts out the ultra high frequencies. Look, the art of EQing is complicated, and while you may feel like I rushed these specifics of my settings, just know that a full video on the basics of EQing would probably take a lot longer than the length of this video right here. So this is a good starting point for any voice. Feel free to copy these exact settings and then tweak from there. Next, we're going to use the same process, VST2.x plugin, giving it a name, to add TDR Molotok. Let me scroll down and find that. And again, hopefully this shows up if you follow the installation process correctly. But this is a compressor, which essentially reduces the volume of the audio once it passes a certain point. The threshold knob controls that point, and Opening the settings, you can see that I set it to roughly the average volume of my voice when I'm speaking. You can tell where that is by watching the indicator move as your mic picks up sound. And then the ratio is how intensely the compressor will reduce the audio's volume, and I have it relatively high because streaming generally involves a good range of volumes. And the attack and release speeds, similar to the noise gate, are the speeds at which the compression is applied. Feel free to copy mine for a good starting point. Next is the last third-party plugin, TDSer. We type that in, then we're going to select it from the dropdown. And a de-esser does exactly what it sounds like, attacks these frequencies to an extent that you can control. In this case, that's what the massive knob here does, and to set this to the right level, I recorded several instances of saying something with a lot of S sounds, she sells shells down by the seashore, stuff like that, but with each one having a different level of de-essing. And then going back and listening to that and kind of just tweaking until I felt like I got the right level of de-essing. If you ever watch my other audio editing guides, I generally put de-essing before compression. But again, I'm optimizing this for streaming, and I'm aware that streaming volumes can go from 0 to 100 sometimes, so I made sure we got the compressor on here to even out volumes, and then the de-esser. Alright, the last two plugins on here are a limiter and gain, which I'm using in combination as essentially a stock version of something like Loudmax. But let me go ahead and hit that plus sign, and then add the limiter, okay, and then do the gain, okay, and then I'll explain some more. So the combination of these two plugins essentially removes headroom, the extra space between the levels your audio is hitting after the edits and the max volume of 0 decibels. So basically, I set the limiter, look at that right here, to 16 decibels to squash the remaining peaks in the audio, think like the loudest 5% of the audio. This is obviously the levels I was hitting after my edits on my mic and voice, so make sure to set yours to where the top, you know, roughly 5% of your volumes are hitting. But for me, knowing that anything above negative 16 is squashed by the limiter, I can make a new max volume of 1 decibel below that by setting the gain to plus 15. So if you look at the gain, that makes sense, right? 16 minus 5 is 1. The gain brings up the volume almost to max, leaving 1 decibel of headroom. Now, I know 1 decibel is standard for podcasts, and it's okay for voiceover where you can bring things down even more in a video editor, but keep in mind, you may need to add more headroom if you're using other sources of audio in your stream. Think like background music, other people, or sound effects. So, if I wanted 3 decibels of headroom, I'd just set the gain to 13 decibels, and do the math, and you get 3 decibels of headroom. But besides that, that's the effect. You've been getting a live preview of these filters as I dropped on the effects in the course of the video. Do keep in mind I boosted the levels of the earlier parts for ease of listening, so the limiter and gain might have seemed like they had a subtler effect than they actually did. But regardless, I hope you enjoyed these edits and hope you're able to put them to use for your own streaming needs. Feel free to be non-spammy and drop your own stream info down in the comments as long as you're, you know, respectful about it. And hopefully I'd like to hear that you're using these effects to make your own streaming audio sound better. But besides that, you know, subscribe to this YouTube channel for more knowledge and more tech videos. I appreciate you being here today, and I'll see you in the next one.